Sunday once again. Excited na lahat na makinig ng salita ng Panginoon. Pero mas excited sana, no, pag nakikita-kita tayo. Pero malapit na yan. Ilang linggo, ilang buwan. Hindi natin alam kung kailan. Pero sana hindi nagsusubside yung excitement nyo to meet the Lord every Sunday at makinig sa kanyang mga salita. Let's open our Bible, no, sa Psalms 95 verses 1 to 10. Yeah, 1 to 10. I'm reading sa NLT version. Ready na po kayo? Yeah. Amen. Verse 1, Psalm 95. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout joyfully to the rock of our salvation. Let us come to Him with thanksgiving. Let us sing psalms of praise to Him. For the Lord is great God, a great King above all gods. He holds in His hands the depths of the earth and the mightiest mountains. The sea belongs to Him, for He made it. His hands form the dry lands. 2. Come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker, for He is our God. We are the people He watches over, the flock under His care. The Lord says, don't harden your hearts as Israel did Meribah, as they did at Massah in the wilderness. For there your ancestors tested and tried my patience, even though they saw everything I did. For 40 years, I was angry with them, and I said, they are a people whose hearts turn away from me. They refuse to do what I tell them. Amen. Blessed His word. Alam niyo, no, itong pandemic, maraming binigay sa atin nabungkal yung ating fear. Nabungkal din yung ating faith. At ang sabi ng Panginoon, magstay tayo sa Kanya. Maniwala at magtiwala lang. Hindi tayo, huwag nating dapat gayahin yung ginawa ng Israel. Amen? Amen. I-prepare natin ating mga puso, no, sa praise and worship, para pagsamba. Let us pray. Father God in heaven, we praise and worship you. Pinapasalamatan ka namin, O God, sa patuloy mo na pag-protection. Sa patuloy, Panginoon, na pagbibigay mo ng grasya at awa sa bawat isa sa amin. Holy Spirit, patuloy mo kaming hubugin, O God, na naaayon sa salita ng Diyos Ama, na, Lord, O God, itong dinadaanan namin ngayon, Lord, hindi kami, Panginoon, maging balakid, hindi ito maging balakid sa aming pagtubo. Buksan mo ang aming mga tenga, ang aming mga puso, O God, para, Lord, tumubo kami, marinig namin ang iyong mga salita. Maitanim yun sa aming mga puso. Hallelujah, Lord. Maraming salamat, Panginoon. Lord, O God, tulungan mo kami magbago. Tulungan mo kami lumakad ng matuwid. Tulungan mo kami, Panginoon, na magpuri, Lord, O God, at magpasalamat ng walang hanggan sa matamis na pangalan ni Jesus. Amen. Amen and amen.
Sing the song, magasinggit, mag-aawit. This is our chance, no, na magdayag ka sa ginoigsoon, no matter what. Kung asa makakaroon, you are free to give praise to the Lord. You can sing, you can dance, you can hop, you can jump. Anything that you wanna do for the Lord. And let's sing this song, magasinggit, mag-aawit. 1, 2, 3.
Magkaduol kami kanimo, amahan, uban sa pagpaubos sa among kaugalingon. Magaduol kami kanimo, amahan, pagadaigun ka, pagadaigun ka, magaduol kami kanimo, amahan, uban sa pagpaubos sa among kaugali. Magaduol kami kanimo, amahan, uban sa pagpataas sa among mga pagdahig. Magasinggit, magaawit sa pagadaigun ka, pagadaigun ka. Magalukso, magasayaw, mga kamot, igabayaw. Magasinggit, magaawit, sa pamaya magadahig. Magalukso, magasayaw, ang ngalan mo, igabayaw. Magasinggit, magaawit, sa pamaya magadahig. Magalukso, magasayaw, mga kamot, igabayaw. Magasinggit, magaawit, sa pamaya magadahig. Magalukso, magasayaw, mga kamot, igabayaw. Magasinggit, magaawit, sa pamaya magadahig. Magalukso, magasayaw, ang ngalan mo, igabayaw. Magasinggit, magaawit, sa pamaya magadahig. Magalukso, magasayaw, mga kamot, igabayaw. Magasinggit, magaawit, sa pamaya magadahig. Magalukso, magasayaw, ang ngalan mo, igabayaw. Magasinggit, magaawit, sa pamaya magadahig. Magalukso, magasayaw, ang ngalan mo, igabayaw. 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 Magalukso, magasayaw, ang pagadaigun ka, pagadaigun ka, pagadaigun ka.
Lord, you are worthy to be praised, to be worshipped today. Lord, napakasarap po na purihin ka, bigyan ka ng papuri, Lord. Hallelujah. Sa buhay ko, ikaw ang bukas. Sa lahat ng suliranin ko, ikaw ang siyang lunas. Sa puso ko, ikaw ang nais. Pag-ibig mo, O Diyos, o kay tamis. Sa buhay ko, ikaw ang bukas. Sa lahat ng suliranin ko, ikaw ang siyang lunas. Sa puso ko, ikaw ang nais. Pag-ibig mo, O Diyos, o kay tamis. Napakasarap magpuri sa kanlungan mo. Lahat ng nais ng puso'y natatagpuan sa'yo. Nang aalalahanin pa, nakapaligid man ang problema, basta't ikaw, basta't ikaw, basta't ikaw, O Diyos ang kasama. Sa buhay ko, ikaw ang bukas. Sa lahat ng suliranin ko, ikaw ang siyang lunas. Sa puso ko, ikaw ang nais. Pag-ibig mo, O Diyos, o kay tamis. Lahat ng nais ng puso'y natatagpuan sa'yo. Napakasarap magpuri sa kanlungan mo. Wala nang aalalahanin pa. Nakapaligid man ang problema. Basta't ikaw, basta't ikaw, basta't ikaw, O Diyos ay kasama. Hallelujah, Lord. Sa mga bisig mo lang, O Lord, kami po ay nagkakaroon ng peace, O Jesus. Peace inside, inner peace, Lord. Hallelujah. You deserve all our worships, O Jesus. Basta andito ka lang, Lord, okay po kami, Panginoon. Basta't kasama ka lang namin, Lord, okay po kami, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Basta't ikaw, basta't ikaw, basta't ikaw, O Diyos ay kasama. basta't ikaw, basta't ikaw, basta't ikaw, o Diyos ay kasama. Hallelujah, Lord. Jesus.
Hi everyone, maayong buntag kanatong tanan. Welcome sa atong online Sunday service. My name is Pastor Glenn. Sa tanan natong mga kaubanan sa CCFF o sa ato ang mga visitors, mga first timers, no? O mga relatives, mga friends nga naga-tune in for the first time. Welcome kaninyong tanan sa ato ang Sunday service. So, this is Christ-centered Family Fellowship, the church that welcomes you as you are. In our church, mga igsoon, we don't promote a religion. What we are promoting is a personal and intimate relationship with our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? So today, mga igsoon, let us be excited. Let us prepare our hearts for the Lord. No, tagaan na to si Lord, o pinaka the best nga focus, mga igsoon, sa pagpaminaw siyang pulong kaong buntaga. Because kaong buntaga na ay gi-prepare si Lord na word para sa tuhang tanan to encourage us sa tuang mga kinabuhi and to look forward sa tuang bright future, mga igsoon. Amen? So if ready na ka, mga igsoon, o ready na po ang imuhang katapat, no, I'd like to invite everyone to come before the Lord in prayer this morning. So as we start our word for today. Amen? Let us bow down our heads and let us pray. Hallelujah, Father God, Lord, precious Holy Spirit, Lord, we thank you, O God, for this wonderful time na imuhaming gigather, O God, as a family. Lord, thank you for the gift of life. Lord, thank you for the wonderful relationship that we have, O God, with our family, with our friends, with our loved ones, O God. Lord, thank you for our work. Thank you for our businesses, O God. Thank you for our studies, O God. Thank you for the good health. Lord, thank you for everything, O God, even for all the trials and testings, O God. Lord, thank you also, O God, because it is, even though that we undergo those things, O God, well, yun minimo gibiyaan, O God. Lord, salamat kayo, O God, for this time. I pray na kang buntaga, Lord, makigistorya ka kanamo. Lord, mangayo mi pasaylo, O God, sa tanan namong mga sala, namong nabuhat, O God. And today, Lord, renew our strength, renew our faith, O God. I pray, Father God, that, Lord, mag-minister yung ka kanamo kang buntaga, Lord. And Lord, ma-encourage me, O God, sa imong mga pulog. And we will receive our portion this morning, O God. Lord, salamat sa tanan. Thank you for the presence of everyone, O God. I pray nga ikaw mag-bless sa matag-usa ka na mo kong buntaga, O God. Lord, salamat, O God. And whatever we accomplish this morning, O God, Lord, ginabalik na mo daan, O God, ang tanang dungog o gimaya, Lord God. Ya, kanimo lamang, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. No, ato ang tagaan si Lord o pinakadagang likes, pinakadagang hearts, mga igsoon, o mag-commenta sa comment section o kanang mga words of praises para kay God na ay hallelujah, I love you Jesus, thank you Lord, no, tanang mga words of praises ato ang ihatag niya kay Lord kay kanang He deserves all our praises and thanks, mga igsoon, because God is good and He is good all the time. Amen? Okay? So, before tamo ato sa to ang word for today, no, quick recap lang sa to ang word last Sunday, no, sa tanang mga naka-tune in, no, sa tong title sa to ang topic last Sunday. So ang title sa tong topic last Sunday is Batch of 2021. So ang main message atong word na gihatag ni Lord sa to at true kay Pastor Jobert is that kina-encourage ta ni Lord na we should end this year 2021 with a bang, meaning atuag yun siyang humanon, mga igsoon, nga madasigon, dili magluya, no, dili mag kalayo, but magkalayo ta sa tuang mga kinabuhi labaw na sa tuang relasyon diya kay God, no, despite of all the pandemics, mga igsoon, kinangla nato humanon makagraduate ta sa year 2021 with flying colors, mga igsoon. And on that topic, mga igsoon, no, naghatag si Lord sa tua, no, ato kay Pastor Jobert, 3 guides to finish 2021 well. Number 1 guide, mga igsoon, ingon pa dito, face your fears. no, face your fears. Kay ingon pa dito mga igsoon, when you are fearless, you become limitless. Amen. So let us face our fears mga igsoon. And second guide mga igsoon is i-share ni Lord sa toa is forget your failures, no. Ato ang kalimtan, ato ang mga failures, past is past. Let's learn the lesson from it and let's move forward sa itong kinabuhi. And number three, last but not the least, is follow your faith. So kinanglan kita nga naagyutay pagtuo diya kay Lord. Because without faith, we cannot please God. And dili makapanglihok si Lord sa itong kinabuhi kung wala tay pagtuo. So let us follow our faith in order to be victorious sa itong kinabuhi. Kinanglan kita dunay pagtuo diya kay God. Amen? So I hope and I pray nga na-encourage ta sa word last Sunday and nagatuag yun ang i-apply karong sa to ang kinabuhi mga igsoon, especially kay nana lang tay less than 2 months before the year 2021 ends. Amen? Okay? So for this morning mga igsoon, at we have another topic that is very interesting. As we all know mga igsoon, we are in the month of November last Monday holiday and some Tuesday kay we sa mga especially sa mga Catholic no gina celebrate nila ang kanang All Souls Day and All Saints Day. And during that time mga igsoon, we are reminded sa tuang mga loved ones nga nauna na nga nipanaw dinhi sa kalibutan. And our topic mga igsoon is somehow related to that, and because whether we like it or not, moabot magyud ang time nga mo-end ang atoong kontrata ning kalibutan na. So the title of our topic for this morning mga igsoon is called Final Destination. So what is our final destination mga igsoon? And in this topic mga igsoon, we will discuss the truth about heaven and hell. So ato ang diskusan ang topic about heaven and hell mga igsoon, because as we all know, heaven and hell are real and gi-mentioned yun na sa Bible so many times mga igsoon, especially ang hell mga igsoon, to emphasize that they are real. And let us talk about this mga igsoon, because this is very important. Mauni ang maghatag na to guide kaninga topic po nga para kung sa to ang final destination po hon mga igsoon. Amen? So to start with this topic mga igsoon, I'd like to ask everyone, imagine there is no heaven.
Imagine there's no heaven.
It's easy if you try.
It's easy if you try.
No hell below us.
No hell below us.
Above us is only sky.
Imagine all the people. Imagine all the people.
Just living for today.
Living for today.
Okay. So that was the 1971 John Lennon song called entitled Imagine, no? So why I played that song? Because that song, mga igsoon, it came to my mind because that's a song about one thing, there be no eternity beyond here and now. So, mauna siya ang kanta, mga igsoon, based sa lyrics nga, imagine all people living for today. No hope or of anything beyond this life. This is good as it gets. So, kaninga song, mura siya ang yang message, mga igsoon, wala na life after here dinhi sa kalibutan. So mo na ang kuan nga song, and that is related sa to ang topic kang buntaga mga igsoon. That is why I played that song mga igsoon, di ba? So mo na nga it's very important for us to understand the truth about heaven and hell based on the word of God, not based on what we experience or what other people said or what the songs played about heaven or hell or about eternity, mga igsoon. Because the truth is, heaven and hell are real, mga igsoon. The Bible speaks about heaven and hell as realities, and so we're going to approach it from that standpoint, mga Igsoon. So, for this morning, mga Igsoon, I'm gonna look at the topic of heaven and hell, and we're going to start with the topic of hell. So, ang una natong i-discuss is ang hell, because I thought that let's finish our sharing for this morning on a high note, no? So, we're gonna start with hell, and we're going to talk also about heaven. Then, I have also prepared a few common questions about heaven na ato ang tubagon later on. So, I want you to listen carefully because this is very interesting and this is very important. So, for our discussion this morning, now we're going to talk about three particular things. No? We'll talk about the intention, the location, and the descriptions of heaven, hell and heaven, mga Igsoon. So, as I start for this topic, mga Igsoon, no, I am reminded by the advice of Charles Spurgeon. Charles Spurgeon, mga Igsoon, is a great British preacher in the 19th century. He said once to his students, ingon pa siya, mga Igsoon, na, "When you speak of heaven, let your face radiate with the glory of God." No? Mo igiingon ni Charles Spurgeon, mga Igsoon, kung magisgot daw tag langit, mga Igsoon, dapat ang atuang face mo radiate siya sa glory ni Lord. And he added, mga Igsoon, ingon pa siya, "But when you speak on the topic of hell, just your regular face will do." No? So, dili na daw kailangan kung just a regular face will do. So, napo siya point ang istorya ni Charles Spurgeon, mga Igsoon, nung sometimes atong experience din sa kalibutan, no, mura na po o naka-experience tag impyerno tungod sa mga trials and difficulties, mga Igsoon. But nevertheless, for this morning, we're going to talk about hell, and then we're going to talk about heaven, and we're going to discuss this topic on these three main points: the intention, the location, and the description of each areas, mga Igsoon. So, since I'm going to talk about first with hell, so I'm gonna use my regular face, no, for this moment. And I hope when we get into heaven, it will be more radiant later, mga Igsoon. Amen? Okay? So, let's start with hell, no? So, what is the intention of hell, mga Igsoon? So, unsa ang intention sa nganong naay hell, mga Igsoon? So, before I speak about the intention of hell, mga Igsoon, I just want to make it clear, mga Igsoon, this is a very important point of about hell, mga Igsoon. This is the point, mga Igsoon. God doesn't want anyone to go to hell. Clear? No? God doesn't want anyone to go to hell, and He takes no pleasure in the death of anyone, including the wicked. Amen? Ingon pa din sa 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 9, mga Igsoon, "The Lord is slow in keeping His promise, and as some understand slowness, instead, He is patient with you and not wanting anyone to perish, but everyone to come to repentance." So, dili yung desire ni Lord, wala yung desire si Lord nga mo perish ang tanang tao din sa kalibutan dito sa hell, mga Igsoon. So, dili yung gusto ni Lord nga kitang mga tao mo adto sa impyerno, mga Igsoon. Amen? And ingon pa din sa Ezekiel chapter 18, verse 32, ingon pa si God, "For I take no pleasure in the death of anyone, declares the sovereign Lord. Repent and live." So, wala yun mahimuot si Lord sa kamatayon, no? Sa kalaglagan sa anybody, anyone, din sa kalibutan, mga Igsoon. And ingon pa din sa Ezekiel chapter 33, verse 1, "Say to them, as surely as I live, declares the sovereign Lord, I take no pleasure in the death of the wicked." So, klaro kayo din ni mga Igsoon, no? Nga ang desire, wala yung intention si Lord, no? Dili yung desire ni Lord nga kitang mga tao or anybody among us muadto sa impyerno, no? Mo perish dito sa impyerno, mga Igsoon, o mag-suffer dito, mga Igsoon, no? He takes no pleasure in the death of the wicked. No, I remember Ka-remember mo ato mga igsoon katong time na I think that was way back 2016, 2017 katong gi-invade sa mga Maoti group ang Marawi mga igsoon and luoy kayo ang lugar sa Marawi because nabutang yun sila sa terror mga igsoon and nagkagubot yun ang lugar sa Marawi. And when the time came nga ang mga Maoti group na they were defeated by our military, our soldiers, no? And those men were killed in the battle mga igsoon. In my flesh, no, sa kuang flesh mga igsoon, I was glad for their death. But when I consider God's heart, no, he does not take pleasure in the death, even in the death of the wicked, mga igsoon, because God does not want anyone to be separated from Him. Mauna, mga igsoon, we should not celebrate in the death of the wicked or anybody, mga igsoon, because that is a grievous thing to God, no? Especially when people rejects Him, no, or are separated from Him, no, masakitan si Lord Gadana, mga igsoon. So, I wanna start that by saying in relation to hell, we need to understand that God doesn't want anyone to go there. Okay? Clear? And He takes no pleasure in the death of anyone. Okay? And in particularly, no pleasure in the death of the wicked. So, ang pangutana karon mga igsoon, well, why did God created hell? Or why did hell even exist, mga igsoon? Mauna ang important question karon mga igsoon. So, to answer that question, mga igsoon, here's the short answer. No? Hell was originally intended for Satan and the angels who joined him in the rebellion, against God. So, ang intention, no? Ang original intention sa hell, sa impyerno mga igsoon, it exists because it is for Satan and his angels, those fallen angels who joined Satan in rebellion against God. No? Ingon pa din sa Matthew chapter 25 verse 41, then he will say to those on his left, depart from me, you who are cursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil in his angels. So klaro kay dinhi mga igsoon sa Matthew 25 that the intention, original intention of hell is for Satan in his fallen angels, no? As we all know in the Bible mga igsoon, no, kabalo ta sa nahitabo, no, there was a rebellion in heaven nga nahitabo, which was led by Lucifer and now known as Satan. And he rebelled against God because he wanted to be God himself. So, like God himself, mga igsoon. And in Revelation chapter 12, mga igsoon, it states there that one-third of the angels in heaven joined Lucifer or Satan in rebellion against God. And because of that, they were expelled by God from heaven. No? They were expelled by God from heaven and hell was created, no, was created originally intended for Satan and his angels. That is a place of judgment, place of judgment for Satan and the angels who rebelled against God. Amen. So klaro kay mga igsoon, no, ang intention sa impyerno is para sa kay Satan og sa iyahang mga fallen angels or mga demons na ni-join sa iyahang mga igsoon. So ang next nga question karon mga igsoon, so unsa may meaning ani, no, kani nga intention, original intention sa hell mga igsoon for us as people, no? This is another connection to that mga igsoon, to that intention mga igsoon. Those who joined in Satan's rebellion against God by rejecting Jesus as Savior will likewise experience the same ultimate punishment, no? Ingon pa din sa John chapter 3 verse 36, whoever believes in the Son has eternal life, but whoever rejects the Son will not see life, for God's wrath remains on them. So klaro kay mga igsoon, no? So those people that will joined Satan's rebellion by rejecting Jesus sa ilang kinabuhi as Lord and Savior, will likewise the same, no, will experience the same punishment as Satan and his fallen angels in the place called hell, mga igsoon. So, muna nga, sad to say, no, na may mga tao nga mo rebel gyud kay God, and because of their rebellion, disobedience to God, they did not accept Jesus as their Lord and Savior, they will, in the same way, they will be joining Satan in his fallen angels in rebellion against God. And God is a righteous God, no? And muna nga, if there is a rebellion, there will be separation from God in that place called hell. So, talking about hell also, mga Ikson, there is a common misunderstanding about hell, mga Ikson, among people, among us people in this world. Some says that in hell, there will be kung muadto daw ka sa impyerno, there will be, ang may tabo daw sa tao is, there will be inhalation. When you say inhalation, kanaganing, ang tao daw nga muadto dito sa mabutang sa impyerno, sunugon siya one time, and then mawala na siya. Murag abo inhalation. So, murag kanang mawala ka, mamatay, o maabo, mabanish ka dito sa impyerno. Inhalation, actually, mga Ikson, is a false doctrine because the Bible says, in hell, you will not be inhalated. In fact, you will be perpetually tormented for that rebellion. When you say perpetually, you will be constantly tormented. No? Gusto ka mamatay, pero dili ka mamatay dito, mga Ikson. Gusto ka mabanish, pero dili ka mabanish dito sa impyerno, mga Ikson. And there are also some misconception or common belief among or false doctrine among people, especially even in the church, that is called universalism. Universalism, mga Ikson, is a belief that teaches that God is so loving that at the end, mga Ikson, nobody is really gonna go to hell. And in fact, in universalism, it is believed, therefore, that hell doesn't really even exist, mga Ikson. So, and this doctrine of universalism is also a false doctrine, no? Because hell exists, no? Hell is real, and if we disobey with God, we will pay the punishment of our disobedience because God is a righteous God, and I will explain that further later, mga Ikson, about the righteousness of God, mga Ikson. So, hell exists, klaro kayo, mga Ikson, and the Bible speaks about it, mga Ikson. No, Jesus refers to it more he does than heaven, mga Ikson, and we need to understand that heaven is a place of judgment. It is a place where God doesn't want anyone to go. That's why he sent his son Jesus to die to rescue people so that nobody should go there in hell. But by our choice and rebellion to God, we could in that sense join Satan's rebellion and likewise end up in hell. So muna, bantayan na to, mga Ikson. Okay? So that's the intention of hell, mga Ikson. Okay? So next point is, let's talk about the location of hell. No? To piece together a few passages from the Bible, mga Ikson, it seems that the place that hell is located is in the center of the earth. Okay? No? That is the location of hell, mga Ikson. It is in the center of the earth. So what is our proof for that, mga Ikson? No? No? Because in the Bible, mga Ikson, it says there that after Jesus was crucified, his spirit descended to the lower earthly regions. No? Ingon pa din sa Ephesians 4:9. What does as he ascended mean except that he also descended to the lower earthly regions? Okay? And ingon pa sa Bible, mga Ikson, Jesus said that he would be there 3 days and 3 nights in the heart of the earth. No? I'd like you to encircle heart of the earth, mga Ikson. When you say heart of the earth, it is the center of the earth. No? Matthew chapter 12 verse 40, it says, therefore, as Jonah was 3 days and 3 nights in the belly of a huge fish, So the Son of Man will be 3 days and 3 nights in the heart of the earth. Amen? Okay? So that is the location of the hell, mga Ikson. It is the center, at the center of the earth, mga Ikson. No? It is very interesting also, mga Ikson, in the 1600s, the Puritans in America, no? Puritans, mga Ikson, were English Protestants in the 16th and 17th century, no? They have this kanang custom, mga Ikson, during that time, no, among the Puritans, no. They would greet each other, no? Ilahang mo greet sila sa matag usa as they would pass by each other, mga Ikson. So in the first person would say, "Heaven is high," and then the second person na ilang gikatagbo mingon pud siya, "Hell is low." And today that's been abbreviated as hi and hello. So diha dai gikan ang kanang greetings nato, mga Ikson, nga hi and hello, no? It actually came from the traditional Puritan greetings to remind each other that heaven is high and hell is low. So hi and hello, those common greetings today came from that Puritan greeting. So muna, mga Ikson, nga hell, the location of hell is at the center of the earth. So how far down, no? I don't know specifically, but it is at the very center of the earth. It is beneath us, it is below us, mga Ikson. Okay? So klaro ba ta, mga Ikson? Okay? So now let's go to the description about hell, mga Ikson. So when we look at the scripture, mga Ikson, how hell is described, no? I have some bullet points for each one of us, mga Ikson. So hell is described in the word of God as a place with eternal fire, non-consuming and non-illuminating. Ingon pa din sa Matthew 25 verse 21, no? Then he will say to those on his left, "Depart from me, you who are cursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels." So encircle the word eternal fire. Doon ay kalayo dito, mga Ikson, nga dili mapalong. Eternal man siya. No, walay bumbero dito, no, sa impyerno, no? Kay ang kalayo dito eternal, dili siya mapalong, no? And ingon pa din ni non-consuming, no? Ingon pa din ni sa Mark 8:12, "The worms," na day worms dito, mga Ikson, sa impyerno, "that eat them do not die, and the fire is not quenched," no? The fire is not quenched, meaning ang kalayo dito dili mapalong. Klaro kay na, mga Ikson, okay? And ingon pa din sa Matthew 8:12, "But the subjects of the kingdom will be thrown outside into the darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth." No, I'd like you to insert, to highlight the word "into the darkness." No, no, kanang murag ang lugar sa impyerno, mga Ikson, dunay fire, dili mapalong, pero non-illuminating. There is total darkness dito sa impyerno, no? Lahi siya. Lahi ragyo dito, mga Ikson. Ang kalayo dito, lahi, no? Kalayo siya, pero non-illuminating na fire, because there is total darkness in hell, no? Kasi naka-experience ninyo din nga na-isolate mo sa isa ka lugar nga ngit-ngit yun, no? I remember before, mga Ikson, katong bata pa ko, no, kusog man kayo mi sa una kanang modula og kanang spider damang, and ang among ginabuhat is manguha mi og damang sa gabi, kay gabi man na mo gawas ang damang nya magbalay. So among ginabuhat, magdala mig sulo kanang ganing lampara or something nga among suga kayo, wa pa man nauso kayo, mahal pa man flashlight ato nga time. So kung among ginabuhat at tumig kanang mga suok nga lugar, kanang mga dagang kahoy, kanang sa mga maisan, no, kay naa diha ang mga daghang damang. And one time nangita mig damang, ako nagdala kog sariling ako ang kanang sulo nako or kanang suga nako lampara. And then nisiparit ko sa grupo kay usay maginilugay manggod, so nangita kog akoa, and naa sila sa unahan, and ngit-ngit kayong lugar niya, lampara gyud ang ako ang suga. And sa kakusog sa hangin, mga igso, napalong ang ako ang lampara. And dito for the first time na feel na ko ang kahadlok, no? Ang darkness, mga igsoon. And dito na ko na experience nga kung naaday ka sa darkness, mga igsoon, you will also feel loneliness. Why? Because you feel alone man, wala man di man kay makita ng laing tao, wa kay magunitan or something, no? So you feel alone, there is fear, there is loneliness. So darkness and loneliness are magsabay yun na, mga igsoon. When there is darkness, you will also feel lonely or loneliness. Mabito ng mga tao nga lonely, mayingon, may describe sila hang experience as the dark experience of their life. So maupod na ato ang naado sa impyerno, mga igsoon. No, there is an eternal fire, non-consuming, no, dili siya mapalong, but non-illuminating, no, ang kalayo dito, mga igsoon. And there is total darkness dito sa impyerno. And kaganina, no, sa Matthew chapter 9, naka-describe po dito, there is a worm, no, naday worm dito nga mo gawa sulod sa lawa sa tao, nga dili pod mamatay ang worm. Ambot nga noon, sana siya nga klase nga worm. But maunang ginaistorya sa Bible, mga igsoon. Okay? And the second description about hell, mga igsoon, in hell, this is a place of torment and misery. No? Ingon pa din sa Matthew 13:42, they will throw them into the blazing furnace where they will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. No? When you say weeping, so because of misery, no? Grabe ang hinilakay dito. And gnashing of teeth because of torment, because of pain, because of suffering, mga igsoon. Diba? Usay ka ng batiyon, tagkasakit, ka ng tambalan atong samad, nga hapdos kayo, diba? Mapaakon man ato itong ngipon. Kala muna nga mag-gnash ato ang teeth because of the pain. In moda na yung ma-experience sa tao nga mabutang sa impyerno, mga igsoon. There will be torment and misery na yung ma-experience. And third, mga igsoon, there will be a conscious awareness that something is better but unattainable, no? And ang passage na ito ma-relate ani mga igsoon based sa word ni God is the story of the rich man and Lazarus, mga igsoon, sa Luke chapter 16 verse 19 to 31, no? As we all know that the rich man, no, he committed idolatry and he didn't follow God and he end up in hell, mga igsoon, and he cries out to across this chasm to the place that was called Abraham's side, and he begged Abraham to dip his finger in water and come over to the rich man and quench his thirst in because he was in torment. But Abraham said to the rich man, "No, I can't come to where you are." So it is a place where we are aware, mga igsoon, that there is something better. Pero dili na to ma-attain, mga igsoon. And that in himself, mga igsoon, is tormenting, mga igsoon, sa to ang apart. No? Kanaganing kabalo ka that there is something better, pero dili yun din mo ma-attain, mga igsoon, sa imuhang situation. Mauna nga, that is a very tormenting na experience, mga igsoon. Amen? And the last description that I'm gonna share this morning about hell, mga igsoon, it is a place, no, that the realization of the separation from God's presence, no, you will realize that you are separated from God. You will not experience the presence of God in that place called hell, mga igsoon. Ingon pa din ni 2 Thessalonians 1 chapter 1 verse 8 to 9, he will punish those who do not know God and do not obey the gospel of our Lord Jesus. They will be punished with everlasting destruction and shut out from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of His might. So, as we all know that God is omnipresent God. He is everywhere. But apparently, He restricts His presence in some way in hell, mga igsoon. And because of that, no, we have, if the person end up in hell, no, they have no ability, no, to experience the presence of God in their lives, mga igsoon, because hell, no, it is a place of separation from God's presence, mga igsoon. Amen. So are you learning something, mga igsoon, no? So, mao na ang hell, mga igsoon, mao na iyang intention, mao na iyang location, og mao na iyang description. And now, let's go to heaven. No? Are you ready for heaven, mga igsoon? Kasi ready sa heaven, mga igsoon, no? Say amen sa tuang live stream, okay? So, let's talk about the intention of heaven. So, the intention of heaven, mga igsoon, is it is the habitation of God and the eternal home for those who have trusted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. No? It is presently occupied by God. He's on the throne, mga igsoon. And those who know Jesus as Lord and Savior, when they die, their spirit separates from their body and they go to be with the Lord in His presence in heaven. Ingon pa din sa 1 Kings chapter 8, verse 30, hear the supplication of your servant and of your people Israel when they pray towards this place. Hear from heaven, your dwelling place, when you hear and forgive. Amen? So it is God's dwelling place, mga igsoon, ang heaven. And in Psalm 103 verse 19, ingon pa din ni, the Lord has established His throne in heaven. So klaro kay mga igsoon, no? Trono sa Ginoo ang langit, mga igsoon. And His kingdom rules over all. Okay? And no? And 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 6 to 8, no? Ingon pa din ni, therefore we are always confident and know that as long as we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we live by faith, not by sight. We are confident, I say, would prefer to be away from the body and at home with the Lord. No? So when we die, no, ang our spirit will be separated from our body and will be at home with the Lord. Okay? Mauna ang heaven, mga igsoon. Okay? And inyong pa din sa Revelations 21 to 27, verse 27, nothing impure will ever enter it, nor will anyone who does what is shameful or deceitful, but only those whose names are written in the book, in the Lamb's book of life. Okay? So, kinsa tong mga names nga masulat sa Lamb's book of life are those people who accepted Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Okay? So, that's the intention of heaven, mga igsoon. No? God's intention of heaven, it is a place. It is a place of habitation, of His habitation, mga igsoon, no? In our eternal home for Christians when we die. Okay? So, next, how about the location? The location of heaven is somewhere above the earth, beyond outer space, no? Ingon pa din sa 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 1 to 2, I must go on boasting, although there is nothing to be gained, I will go on to visions and revelations from the Lord. I know a man in Christ who 14 years ago was caught up to the third heaven. Now, I'd like you to highlight that the word third heaven, where whether it was in the body or out of the body, I do not know. God knows. So, the third heaven ang gina-emphasize ni Paul din sa 2 Corinthians chapter 12. No? Paul emphasized here the word third heaven, mga igsoon. So, what does it mean, the word third heaven, mga igsoon? So, actually, when we say heaven, mga igsoon, sa Bible, no, kay wala pa man na define ang mga atmosphere ato nga time, ang ilahang description, mga igsoon, about sa atmosphere, no, nato, din sa kalibutan, no, itawag nilag heaven also. So, ang first heaven, no, it refers to our earth atmosphere, no? Actually, the word heavens, mga igsoon, in the plural terms, no, are used 600 times in the Bible, mga igsoon. And when we speak of first heaven, mga igsoon, it talks about the earth's atmosphere. And the second in the second heaven is what we would call as the outer space. Muna siya ang second heaven. And the third heaven is where God dwells, which is beyond outer space, mga igsoon. Okay? Mauna ang gi-describe ni Paul din sa 2 Corinthians chapter 12, the third heaven or a place that is beyond the outer space, mga igsoon. Okay? In Psalm chapter 14 verse 2, the Lord looks down from heaven on all mankind to see if there are any who understand any who seek the Lord. So it is very clear that heaven, it is up above, and God looks down from heaven, kaya naaman siya siyang tono karon. And we and kita, when we die, we also ascend to heaven if we became a Christian and accepted Christ as our Lord and Savior. So klaro ba na mga igsoon ang location sa langit or sa heaven, mga igsoon? No, it is somewhere above the earth, beyond outer space. Okay, so asa na siya dapita? I don't know specifically, no, but makaabot kata diha pohon kung maabot na ito ang time nga mo ato sa langit, mga igsoon. Amen? So, the description of heaven. So, what is the description of heaven? No? The description of heaven, God says in this word that it is a street of gold. No? A place with street of gold, gates of pearl, and the foundations are costly stones. And it is also a place, mga igsoon, that is illuminated solely by the presence of God in His glory. Dito sa heaven, mga igsoon, wala na'y kuan dito, wala na'y sun, wala na'y moon, wala na'y stars. No, wala na po'y double light dito, or wala na po'y kanang kuan dito, mga Christmas lights or unsa ba. Because that place is being illuminated by the presence and the glory of God. And ingon pa din isa, no, just to emphasize the description about the how beautiful heaven is, mga igsoon, no? Let us read, no, Revelation chapter 21 verse 15 to 21. Taas-taas ni mga igsoon, but I'd like to read this because this is very important to emphasize how beautiful heaven is, no? Ingon pa din ni mga igsoon, the angel who talked with me had a measuring rod of gold to measure the city, its gates and its walls. The city was laid out like a square, as long as it was wide. He measured the city with a rod and found it to be 12,000 stadia in length, and as wide as high as it is long. The angel measured the wall using human measurement, and it was 144 cubic thick. Then the wall was made of jasper, no, a precious stone, jasper, mga igsoon. In the city of pure gold, as pure as glass. So, ang gold daw dito, mga igsoon, the city, ang street is pure gold, pure as glass. No? Tinaw kaayo, no? Clear kaayo, mga igsoon. And the foundation of the city walls were decorated with every kind of precious stone. No? Muni ang mga foundation, mga igsoon. No? 12 foundations, no? The first foundation is jasper. The second is sapphire. The third is agate. The fourth is emerald. The fifth is onyx, the sixth is ruby, the seventh is chrysolite, the eighth is beryl, the ninth is topaz, the eighth is turquoise, the 11th is jacinth, and the 12th is amethyst. The 12 gates were 12 pearls, each gate made a single pearl. The great city, the great street of the city was gold, as pure as transparent glass. Amen? And I do not see a temple in the city because the Lord Almighty God and the Lamb are its temple. No? The city does not need sun or moon to shine on it, for the glory of God gives it light, and the Lamb is its lamp. Amen. So, klaro kay mga igso, no? That is the beautiful description of heaven. No? Maybe ang atong imagination is only limited, mga igso, when you talk about kanang the beauty of heaven, mga igsoon, because in this world, we only have three primary colors, no? Red, yellow, and blue. And out of that primary colors comes the rest of the color wheel, mga igsoon. But I believe, mga igsoon, no, that this is not confirmed in the Word of God, but based on the Kanisha, when John wrote this passage, mga igsoon, he describes it to the best of his ability. No, pero I believe when dito siguro sa langit, mga igsoon, no, there will be more than three primary colors, mga igsoon, no, and can you imagine that, more the beauty of that, mga igsoon, more than three primary colors, and out of that the combination of other colors, mga igsoon, and how beautiful it is, mga igsoon, when we see that, when we arrive in heaven one day, mga igsoon. Amen. So that is the description of heaven. And another good bullet points about the description of heaven, mga igsoon, it is a place of no mores. When you say no mores, no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain. No, that is the description of heaven. No, ingon pa din ni sa Revelations 21 verse 4, He will wipe every tear from their eyes, and there will be no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain, for the old order of things has passed away. Amen? So, is it good news para sa tuwa tanan mga igsoon? No? Especially if you are a Christian. No? One day will come that there will be no more. We will be in the place where there will be no more pain, no more crying, no more death, mga igsoon. Muna, mga igsoon, this passage, mga igsoon, also answers the question among people nga, kanang pastor, ang ako ang example, ako ang parent ba nga namatay sa langit karon, kabalo kaya sila pastor unsay nahitabo di sa kalibutan, no? And the answer to that, mga igsoon, wala na sila idea unsay nagapangitabo sa kalibutan, mga igsoon, because in heaven there will be no more pain, no more crying, no? No more death, mga igsoon. It is a place of peace, mga igsoon. So kung kita naaka sa langit and makabalo pa ka unsay nagapangitabo sa kalibutan, do you think maging at peace ka dito sa langit nga makita nimo imong family din sa kalibutan nga nagasuffer? No, I don't think so. Dili ka maging happy dito. So I believe when we get into heaven, we don't have any more ideas about what's happening on this earth, mga igsoon. Amen. Okay? So that is the heaven, mga igsoon, a place of no mores, no? No more death, no more mourning or crying or pain. Another last but not the least description, mga igsoon, about heaven, it is a place of reunion with loved ones and friends who knew Christ as Savior. So there, it is a place of reunion, mga igsoon. Magkita-kita ta dito sa tuang mga loved ones, sa tuang mga lulog, lula, mga igagaw, mga relatives, mga friends, mga igsoon. Mag-abot-abot ta dito sa tuang mga cell members, mga leaders, no? Mag-abot-abot ta tanan dito. Ingon pa din sa Matthew 8, verse 11, I say to you that many will come from east to west, from the east in the west, and will take their place at the feast with Abraham, Isaac, Jacob in the kingdom of heaven. No, I highlighted the word feast. Kay kung na-reunion yun, nag-unay fiesta. Amen? Okay? And Matthew 17, verse 3 to 4. No? Then, it says here, there appeared before them Moses and Elijah talking with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus, Lord, it is good for us to be here. If you wish, I will put up three shelters, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. So this is the passage, mga igsoon, wherein si Jesus na ato siya sa mountain, na meet siya kang Moses and Elijah. And Peter, na-recognize niya si Moses and si Elijah. And imagine mo, mga igsoon, that Moses and Elijah existed more than 100 years before the disciples. And si Peter, nakaila siya kang Moses and Elijah. So this simply says that when we get into heaven, no, magkaila-ila gyud ta dito, mga igsoon, no, mailha na to ang matag usa, bisan pa to atong mga kalululuhan, no, nga wala na to naabtan samtang nata din sa kalibutan, makaila na to dito kung mag-abot ta dito sa langit, mga igsoon, because that is a place of reunion, mga igsoon. Mao na siya ang heaven, no. And ingon pa din sa 1 Thessalonians 4:17, after that, we who are still alive in our left will be caught up together with them in the clouds. Caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. So we will be with the Lord forever. So this is the passage, mga igsoon, talks about the rapture. No, katong before mo abot ang Antichrist, mga igsoon, there will be a rapture. Katong mga nabilin dinhi nga mga faithful kay God, no, ma-rapture ta ni Lord, kuwaon ta ni Lord, no, padong dito sa langit, and we'll be caught up together, and we will have reunion with our loved ones and friends nga naa dito sa langit, mga igsoon. So that is the description of heaven, mga igsoon, no. Nindot kayo siya nga place nga kanang it's a beautiful place beyond imagination, and a place of no more pain, no more crying, no more death, no? And it is a place of reunion. No mo na nga dili ta mag-uol mga igsoon kung dunay mubiya sa tuang pamilya kay labaw nagnakaila kay Jesus, kay one day magkaroon ta grand reunion dito sa langit mga igsoon, og maglipay ta tanan dito, no? Dito sa langit, okay? So are you learning something about heaven and hell? Okay? So additional questions, no? Before tamato sa questions about more questions about heaven, no? So moni ang iyahang summary about hell in heaven. So mamili ta dini asa ta dapita, dinita sa hell or dinita sa heaven. Of course, heaven gyud ta mga igsoon, layo ka kayo na ang hell, no? It's very extreme opposite mga igsoon. So dinita sa heaven mga igsoon, mon ginato ang goal, mon ato ang desire. Na at the end of our life din sa kalibutan, we will go to heaven to be with God and our loved ones. Okay? So additional common questions about heaven, morning mga common question about heaven mga igsoon. This is just an additional input para sa tuwa tanan. So common question number one, do young children go to heaven when they die? Okay? Munang mga pangutana mga igsoon, especially namang yung mga belief mga igsoon kung wala mabunyagan ang bata daw, dili daw makaadto sa langit, no? In which dili pud na siya tinuod mga igsoon kay wala na siya sa Bible, no? I know mga igsoon, losing a child is one of the most painful experience nato din sa kalibutan, no? But the good news is in the word of God, especially in the second Samuel chapter 12, no? Dito makita nato ang story mga igsoon ni David in Bathsheba, wherein ang ilahang firstborn child, no, baby namatay mga igsoon, and nagkasakit siya at first, and David prayed and fast for his healing, but unfortunately the boy ended up died. And in 2 Samuel chapter 12 verse 23, David said something that is very significant. Ingon pa din si David, I will go to him and he will not return to me, no? So this passage mga igsoon, it simply says that that David is very sure and is very confident that his son or child is in heaven, and one day he will go with to him in heaven. He will join his son in heaven. So this is a very huge theological statement mga igsoon. And I believe this is also true mga igsoon, because God makes gracious provision for children and for those who don't have the capacity or ability to make a decision for Christ, no? So God makes a special provision for children and for those people who don't have a mental capacity or ability to make a decision for Christ mga igsoon, no? Especially katong mga tao mga igsoon nga nay mental disability mga igsoon, no? na experience of abnormality din sa kalibutan. God makes a special provision for them and for those children, no? And because natay ginatawag as age of accountability. And what is the age of accountability? I don't know. Wa ko kabalo. It's between the person and God. But for those children nga wala pa'y capability or ability nga mo decide, even those mga special person nga wala ay ability to make a decision to accept Christ as the Lord and Savior in their life, no, God makes a special provision to them, no, gracious provision to them, because it's unfair naman nga dili sila ka decide and then God will judge them, no, kay wala pa man sila'y accountability. Okay, so children go to heaven when they die, no? O dili na tinuod na dapat mabunyagan para lang kadto sa langit, no? Baptism is not a kanang susi para makaadto ta sa langit, it's only Jesus. But for those children and special person nga walay capability or ability to make a decision, God makes a special provision, gracious provision to them. Okay, clear mga igsoon? Okay, another common important question, do pets go to heaven when they die? So kanang mga pet lover diha nga palangga kay lang mga iho, ilang mga iring, mga langgam, no, or mga lion diha, no. So kani nga question mga Ikson, I'll be careful about this, no, kay dahay mga pet lovers nato din ni. But when we study the word of God in the book of Genesis, no, we consider that God in during the time of creation, God created the plant kingdom, then the animal kingdom, then man. Okay, so animal, no, the animal is created as a living being, no. The Hebrew word for them is nefesh, means it is the word for soul, no. Ang mga animals, mga Ikson, naa sila ay soul. They have the ability to think and to have emotions. On the other hand, ang man, kita, mga tao, were created by God with nefesh and roa. Nefesh, soul, and roa means spirit. So we are a special being because we are the only creation nga naay espiritu kitang mga tao. I wish I could say that your pets would go to heaven, but I cannot say that on the basis of the scripture. However, in the millennial kingdom, based on the word of God, it does speaks about animals. Isaiah talks about animals, mga Ikson. And also in Revelation 19, it says there that Jesus comes to earth on a white horse. So, katong may mga kabayo diya. So, murag nay kabayo siguro sa langit. So, Jesus comes on earth, to earth on a white horse. So, I cannot say specifically, no? Kung ang pets maka muadto ba sa langit hindi dai, because it does not specific, wala gyud siya istorya specific sa Bible. I hope so, no, and may balaan nato na later mga Ikson, but based on the in the creation of God, only humans, kitang mga tao, were created by God with a soul and a spirit, and when we die, atong espiritu muadto dito sa langit. And ang animals, wala man sila yung mga spirito, mga Ikson. They have only a soul. Okay? So, I hope that answers our question, mga Ikson. Next, what becomes our earthly relationship once in heaven? So, with your wife or husband, parents or children, mga Ikson. So, sa itong relationship dito sa langit, mga Ikson, looks like when we go to heaven. No? Jesus said in Luke chapter 20, verse 34 to 36, when we get to heaven, we're gonna be just like angels. Not become an angel, but just, it means just like angels in terms of kanang relationship, mga Ikson. What does it mean, mga Ikson? Jesus specific about that. He said in this passage, mga Ikson, that we will neither be married or be given a marriage, and we will not die. Muna giingon din sa Luke chapter 20, verse 34 to 36, mga Ikson. Which means that our relationship in heaven, mga Ikson, will be different. And all I can say is that in heaven, everything is different. And it's gonna be better then. It's gonna be different then, and better different. So if you are married, so you will not relate with your spouse in heaven in the same way as you relate din sa kalibutan, and also with parents and children. So in heaven, mga Ikson, we will all be brothers and sisters dito sa heaven, and we are all the bride of Christ. So with this verse, mga Ikson, sa Luke chapter 20, verse 34 to 36, so I can come to this conclusion that in heaven, we will be so captured by the presence of God and who Christ is, that our relationship with one another will just be that much better, mga Ikson. So we in heaven, no, we will not be husband and wife or parents or brothers, sisters, mga Ikson, parents, sons and daughters, mga Ikson, dito sa langit, but we will all gonna be brothers and sisters there. kay ang presence ni Lord and knowing Christ, seeing Christ in person dito sa langit, mga igsoon, will be kanang murag mahitabo ang ato ang relationship nato will be much better and we will treat each other as brothers and sisters there in heaven. Okay? And next important question, how old we would be in heaven? Pila nga tong edad kung di nata sa langit, mga igsoon? It's unknown, no, in the Word of God, in the Scripture, it's unknown, wala gistorya sa Bible, mga igsoon. But here's my best guess, mga igsoon, no, about our age in heaven. So, because the ancient rabbis believed that the universal age is 30, no? When you look at the Scripture, mga igsoon, a priest became a priest at the age of 30. Jesus' ministry began at the age of 30. And how old was Adam when God fashioned him? No, when God created Adam, wa man gi-create ni Lord si Adam as a baby. Gi-create man ni Lord si Adam as a matured person na, as a matured human being. The rabbis believe that Adam, when fashioned by God, he was at the age of 30. Although the Word of God does not specifically said that he was 30 years old, but that's what the rabbis believe, mga igsoon. And the Bible doesn't say or is silent about it, but that seems to be a universal age, 30. Even to this day, mga igsoon, the strict Jew, in Jewish custom, mga igsoon, a man cannot read Songs of Solomon until he reached the age of 30. So, my guess, no, our guess, mga igsoon, it might be we are at the universal age of 30 when we get into heaven. No? Why? Because I don't think, mga igsoon, when a little toddler died and went to heaven, I don't believe that he will be stuck or magpabilin siya at the age of a toddler, like, or 4 years old, like, for example, 4 years old. And I don't think when an old man, person, died at the age of 35, muabot siya dito sa langit at the age of 85 also, na wala na siya kusog. And that won't be a fun heaven. That is why I believe, this is some kind of speculative lang yung mga igsoon, ha? But it is somehow sewing together some ideas from the Scripture that the universal age is 30. We are at our prime. One thing is for sure, when we get into heaven, we are the best, we are at the best version of ourselves. Ang pinakapugi nga Glenn, ang pinakagwapa na Ate Vilma, ang pinakagwapo na Pastor Rico, no, Pastor Jotam, no, ang pinakagwapa na Ate Lois, no. So, kita tanan, no, when we get into heaven, we will be at our best version of us. Okay? So, how old would that be? No, dili unknown siya, wala siya istorya sa Bible, but our best guess, universal age is 30 based on the belief of some rabbis, mga igsoon, who studied the Word of God. And last is important question, mga igsoon, last na ni siya, mga igsoon, can we go to heaven even if we are not Christian? The answer for that, mga igsoon, is no. A big no. Because I know it's hard for some people, especially those who are who don't believe in Christ, no, to accept this truth. But the Word of God says that you cannot enter the kingdom of God in heaven if you don't accept Christ as your Lord and Savior. No, the world likes to glamorize that heaven is a place where everybody goes if you are a good person. No, but the Bible tells us otherwise. No, because the Bible says that there is none righteous, not even one, and the Bible says that none of us is in ourselves are good also, mga igsoon. That is why that is the reason why Christianity is the only religion that is different from all other religions in the world. Because all other religions in the world, mga Ikson, basically teach some aspect of striving to be a good person. And to be a good person that would gain you an entrance to heaven, or be reincarnated, or nirvana, or some kind of some aspect of better life later, mga Ikson. But Christianity is the only religion in the world that says you can't earn your way to heaven. None of us deserves our way to be in heaven. None of us are good enough to get there in heaven, mga Ikson. But there is one who was sent on our behalf because of our condition of our soul, that we are not good enough, that we can't go to heaven, we can't work our way to heaven. And there is one person that was sent by God, and His name is Jesus. No? And by His sacrifice on the cross, when we trust what Christ did, and Christ satisfied the wrath of God, no? Because we are all sinners, no? And sin must be punished, mga Iksoon, and because God is a righteous God, and being a righteous God, a righteous judge, no, He will not go sin unpunished, mga Iksoon. He will punish sin. And that is why, because we are all sinners and we cannot attain the standard of God, God sent His one and only begotten Son, mga Iksoon, to die for us on the cross on our behalf, to pay the penalty of sin. And the Bible says that those who believed Him, those who accept Him as His Lord, His or her Lord and Savior, no, promise ni Lord, He will be given the right to become the child of God, and He will be saved. He or she will be saved. And promise ni Lord, no, that He will, and He or she will enter heaven. Not by our merit, mga Iksoon, but by what Jesus did on the cross. We don't need to do anything, no? No. Salvation is by grace through faith in Christ, as what the Bible said. We don't need to do anything. That is why the last word that Jesus said on the cross when He died, mga Ikson, Jesus said, no, as He was about to die on the cross, Jesus said that it is finished. When you say it is finished, mga Ikson, it is done. You cannot add into it, mga Ikson. Amen po tadi, mga Ikson. So, muna, mga Ikson, no, this topic is a realization or a reminder for each one of us that we have to define our final destination kung asa yun ta. No? No? We have our accountability to decide for ourselves. No, ang decision that is not does not should not come from other people, it should come from you. Okay? So as what we have discussed earlier, no, na that the heaven is the most beautiful place, mga Ikson. And we need to our goal is to get into heaven, mga Ikson. And the invitation to heaven, mga Ikson, is wide open to everyone, to anyone. No, ang heaven is for everyone, mga Ikson. But the ability to get there, mga Ikson, is dependent on one way. And what is that one way? The one way is Jesus. No, ingon pa din sa John 14:6, He said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." Okay? So, walay laing susi or passport na to na maka-add to sa langit, mga Ikson. It's only Jesus. Not religion, not good works. Dili ang imong kadato, dili imong kasikat, dili imong kagwapo or kagwapa, mga Ikson. It's only Jesus. By believing in Him, by having faith in Him, and accepting Him as His Lord and Savior. Okay? I hope that you learned something about our topic tonight at this morning, mga Ikson, about final destination, about the truth of heaven and hell. And we should not base our theology or knowledge based on what other people said, but based on the Word of God. And I hope and I pray that you learned something this morning, and I hope that this topic will help you to grow more in your relationship with God. So I'd like to end this hour's service this morning in the prayer. I'd like to pray for each one of us as we end, mga Ikson, and let us dedicate our life to God this morning, mga Ikson, in all our concerns. And let us remember, whatever happens sa kalibutan, if you have Jesus, if you have Jesus, you are in the safest place in your life. Okay? Because no matter what will happen sa kalibutan, you are guaranteed with a passage to heaven. Amen? Okay, let us bow down our heads. Let us pray. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus, precious Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord, for your word this morning. Thank you for reminding us, O God, about our destination, final destination. Lord, we believe that our life here on earth is just temporary. Lumalabay lang may dinigin. And our life on earth is very short. That is why, Lord, we should maximize our time. We should not waste our time with all the negativity din sa kalibutan, with all the worries, with all the doubts, with all our hugot, Lord God. But we should maximize our time to use our life for your glory, to become a blessing to other people, and to glorify you sa among mga kinabuhi, sa among study, sa among trabaho, sa among mga businesses, O God. And when we end, O God, sa among kinabuhi, Lord, before we end this kalibutan, we should make it sure that we have you sa among kinabuhi, Lord, as our Lord and Savior, O God. And one day, Lord God, Lord, when we end our life, we believe that, Lord, one day, Lord, mubalik mi diya kanimo, O God, sa langit, and we will be with you, Lord, nga kauban ka, O God, with all the peace, with all the joy, with all the kalipay, Lord God. No more pain, no more worries, no more sorrow, O God. No more crying, no more death, O God, in heaven. Lord, we look forward for that moment, O God. And while we are still on earth, Lord, help us, Lord God, to use our life for your glory, to live our purpose di sa kalibutan. Lord, daghan big mga problema, daghang mga butang maka-discourage na mo. But I pray, Lord God, that this topic, Lord, will help us, Lord, to remind us, Lord, that we should have no more reasons, O God, nga magpaluya-luya, Lord. Because kabalo mi, O God, nga when we have you, O God, Lord, we are all winners na, O God. We are in the safest place, Lord, which we have you, Jesus. Lord, salamat kay for your word this morning, and I pray for those person who needs healing right now, O God, the mighty name of Jesus, healing in their body, soul, and spirit. Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, I declare healing, O God, sa mga tao karon, O God, especially itong na yung mga gipambati, silang lawas, Lord. Lord, touch their body, touch their head. Lord, touch their heart, O God. Lord, touch their breast, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Touch their stomach, Lord. Touch their feet, O God, every part of their body, in the mighty name of Jesus. I declare healing, and I declare, O God, freedom, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus, O God. Lord, victory diya kanimo, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, thank you so much, and I pray for each one of us, O God, for this coming week. Lord, continue to protect us, encourage us, and bless us, O God. Ilayo mi sa mga disgrasya, Lord, sa mga away, O God. I pray for more victories, Lord, sa mong kinabuhi. And I pray that we will continue to seek you and continue to live for you, O God, this kalibutan. And one day, Lord, ang maenda mong kontrata din sa kalibutan, we will be excited to meet you, O God, and to be with you in heaven. Together with our loved ones, Lord, magkaroon may grand reunion diha, O God, one day. Okay? Lord, salamat kay Lord Jesus. Thank you kayo sa tanan, Lord Jesus, O God. Thank you, Diyo kayo, si mong word. Thank you sa presensya sa matag-usa. Lord, we bless you. We honor you, God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen and amen. And now the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord makes his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord turns his face towards you and give you peace, both now and forevermore. And the people of God will say, amen and amen and amen. Okay, thank you everyone. God bless. And see you on our next Sunday fellowship. Bye-bye.
We would like to invite you next week on our Holy Fire and Ignite Youth Fellowship every Friday at 6 p.m. To our online viewers, thank you so much for tuning into our online Sunday service. See you again next week. God bless.